Last week marked the fourth consecutive week of an increase in COVID-19 cases globally, following 10 weeks of decline. The World Health Organization, WHO, continues to receive reports of hospitals around the world reaching the full capacity of patients as the Delta COVID-19 variant continues to wreak havoc.
The Delta variant is ripping around the world at a scorching pace, driving a new spike in cases and death. Not everywhere is taking the same hit, though. We're in the midst of a growing two-track pandemic where the haves and have-nots within and between countries are increasingly divergent. In places with high vaccination coverage, Delta is spreading quickly, especially infecting unprotected and vulnerable people and steadily putting pressure back on health systems.
For health practitioners who have been involved in what the officials describe as a titanic battle with the disease, with record waiting lists to attend to, increased hospitalization poses a challenge to them and their patients. The WHO has called on countries to think of the impact on health systems and their personnel before lifting public and social measures designed to combat the disease. The situation is terrible in countries with low vaccine coverage, translating into high numbers of hospitalization and death. Even countries that successfully managed the initial waves of the virus are now experiencing devastating outbreaks, particularly in low-income countries where healthcare workers are battling to save lives amid the shortage of personal protective equipment and oxygen.
Vaccines have never been the way out of this crisis on their own, but this current wave is demonstrating again just what a powerful tool they are to battle back against this virus. Delta is now in more than 104 countries, and we expect it to soon be the dominant COVID-19 strain circulating worldwide. The world is watching in real time as the COVID-19 virus continues to change and become more transmissible.
The fact is, the world is experiencing a worsening public health emergency that is threatening lives, livelihoods, and global economic recovery. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.